So, in the second book snapshot, your first chapter is The Summer of a Beautiful White Horse. Now, children, this is a story about two boys. Okay? They belong to a certain tribe, and according to them, the people of their tribe from many generations, they are what? They are poor. Okay? But what is there? They are honest. Okay? They never steal anything. They never lie to the people. They are trustworthy and honest. Fine. So these two boys, they are at the age of their 9. Okay. This is the story of the author only, who has written the chapter, the writer. He was saying that when he was 9, okay, that time he just rided a beautiful white horse. And that horse was brought by his cousin. Okay. His cousin brought this white horse. Okay, but he had a doubt in his heart because they were so poor. Okay, so it was very difficult even to get food for them, and they cannot afford a horse. So he had a doubt in his heart that might be his cousin brother had stolen this horse. But he was also curious, and it was his dream from a long time. It was his desire for him to ride a horse. So that's why he just neglected all these things. Okay, so we start with this, children. One day back there in the good old days when I was 9 and the world was full of every imaginable kind of magnificence and the life was still a delightful and mysterious dream, my cousin Moritz, who was considered crazy by everybody who knew him except me, came to my house at 4 in the morning and woke me up tapping on the window of my room. Now, what is the writer saying? That when I was 9 years old, okay, children at the age of 9, 10, up to 12 years, what the children used to feel, they become curious about things, okay, they used to imagine things, right? So he was saying that I was also like the other students, okay, I was also imagining the things. And at that time, what happened? He was saying at that time what happened, one day he was sleeping and at the time 4 in the morning, okay, his cousin Moritz, he just came to his place, his house, and he just tapped on the window. Okay, he was saying that it was early morning time, 4 o'clock in the morning, and what did the cousin did? He just tapped on the window, okay. He said, I jumped out of the bed and looked out of the window. His cousin called by his name. He just called him by his name. And what happened? The writer jumped out. He was just shocked by seeing his cousin at the window. I couldn't believe what I saw. It wasn't morning yet, but it was a summer with a daybreak. Daybreak means children, dawn, the morning time, the early morning time. So he was saying that I could not believe what I saw outside my window. Okay, he said that it was a morning time. It was not yet morning. Okay, but it was that early morning when the sun started rising. That time, okay, not many minutes around the corner of the world, it was light enough for me to know I wasn't dreaming. And he said that by the dim light, I can even see what I was seeing outside my window. And he said that when I saw that, I realized that I was not dreaming. Okay, my cousin Moritz was sitting on a beautiful white horse. What did he saw? Why he was surprised by seeing the thing outside the window? Because his cousin was sitting on a beautiful white horse. I stuck my head out of the window and rubbed my eyes. He said that still I cannot believe that I cannot believe on my eyes that I was seeing a white horse outside the window. And he said that what happened? I rubbed my eyes just to confirm that what I'm seeing is real. I'm not dreaming. Okay. I stuck my head out of the window and rubbed my eyes. Yes, he said. This is children, Armenia. Armenian is a tribe. Okay, you can write the meaning if you want. Armenian is a official language, or we can say a tribe. It's a tribe. Okay, so it's a tribe, and Armenian is a tribe, and it is their official language. Their official language is also called Armenian. Okay, so they belong to an Armenian tribe. Okay, so he said in Armenian. Armenian is a language. Okay, it's a horse. You are not dreaming. Make it quick if you want to ride. What did his cousin say? The writer's cousin said that in Armenian, in a language, in their own language, that you are not dreaming. It's real. It's a horse. And if you want to ride, then come fast. Come outside. I knew my cousin Lord enjoyed being alive more than anybody else who had ever fallen into the world by mistake. But this was more than even I could believe. What he was saying, that I know that my cousin is full of life. Okay, he wants to enjoy every moment of the life. But he was saying that this I cannot believe that he had a horse right now. Okay, in my first place, my earliest memories had been the memories of the horses. And my first longing means a long desire. Okay, a desire which is from a long time there we are having, but we cannot fulfill it. Okay, and have been longing to ride. He said that in my earlier memory, now the author is remembering his memories. So he was saying that when I was a child, since then only, okay, I have a desire to ride a horse. Okay, and now I can see a horse outside my window. This was the wonderful part. And as a child, his desire is being fulfilled. So it was a very wonderful part for him. Okay. In the second place, we are poor. He said that, yes, it's my desire to ride a horse. But we know that we are poor. It means that we cannot afford a horse. And his cousin was standing outside with a horse. So it's a doubtful, it's a question mark for him that from where he got this horse. Okay, this was the part that wouldn't permit me to believe what I saw. We were poor, we had no money. Our whole tribe was poverty stricken. He was saying that, what is there? We are poor, we don't have money. And our whole tribe is what? Our whole tribe is poverty stricken. Means the Armenian tribes are what? They are so poor that they cannot even afford food for them. And horse, affording a horse is a very big thing. Okay? He was saying each branch of this Gerulin family had living in the most amazing communal poverty in the world. Children, this meaning of Gerulin, Gerulin is an Arabian tribe. Their tribe name is Gerulin. So this is the name of their tribe. Okay, nobody could understand where we ever got money enough to keep our food, to keep us with food in our bellies. Not even the old men of our family. Most important of all, though we were famous for our honesty, we had been famous for our honesty for something like 11 centuries. Even when we had been the wealthiest families in what we like to think was the world. Now, what is there? He was saying like that from 11 centuries, we are famous for our honesty, but we don't have money. He said that even our family, older members, means our ancestors, okay, they are also poor. We are also following the same. We are also poor. Only what we have, honesty. Okay, from 11 centuries, our tribe is famous for only for honesty. You know, he was saying that I don't know from where my brother got this horse. Okay, we are proud, first honest, next, and after we believed in right and wrong. He said that our tribe people are very proud. Why? Because first of all, they are honest. And second thing, we know the differentiation between the right and the wrong. Okay, we can make a difference that what is right and what is wrong for our tribe. Okay, none of us would take advantage of anybody in the world, let alone steal. He said that we, our tribe people, now he was just appreciating his tribe. So the author was saying that our tribe people, the people which belong to our tribe, they have never taken advantage of anyone, and they have never thought in their dreams also to steal anything. Okay, because we are famous for our honesty, our trust. We never take advantage of the people. Although we are poor, then too we never decided to steal. Now this is all things are the qualities of the Armenian tribe. Okay, he was just telling the qualities of his own tribe. Consequently, even though I could see the horse so magnificent, even though I could smell it so lovingly, even though I could hear its beating so exciting, I couldn't believe the horse anything to do with my cousin Moritz or with me or with any of the other members of our family, asleep or awake, because I knew my cousin Moritz couldn't have brought the horse, and if he couldn't have brought it, he must have stolen it. And I refused to believe it, he had stolen it. He said that the horse is just standing in front of me. I can see it, I can smell it, I can feel its breathing. He said that still I don't want to believe that there is a horse standing outside my house. Why? He said that because we are so poor, and I know that even I and all the members of our tribe, of our family, and even my cousin, we cannot afford to buy a horse. And he said that now what the question came into my mind, now I was thinking that as we are poor, we cannot afford a horse. So might be my brother had stolen it. Okay, but what he said in the last line, I refuse to believe he had stolen it. He said, but due to the conditions which are there, due to the pride which we have on our tribe, that we are honest, we never steal. So he said that I was now not believing it also, that he had stolen it. Okay. No member of the Gurgan family could be a thief. He said that the members of a tribe can never be a thief. So that's why I was just not believing it, that my brother had stolen this horse. I stared first at my cousin and then at the horse, and there was a precious stillness and humor in each of them, which on the one hand delighted me and on the other hand frightened. He said that first I look at my cousin and then I look at the horse. And he said that this horse is attracting me a lot. He said that obviously it's my desire. I want to ride a horse. So I was getting attracted to go and ride a horse. So he said that I had both the things. I had a confusion. I was in a dilemma that I want to ride a horse. And on the other hand, I was frightened also that if might be this horse a stolen horse, then what will happen? Okay. Moritz said, where did you steal this horse? Now the author asked the writer, he asked him that from where did you stole this horse? Leap out of the window, he said, if you want to ride. And what did the cousin of the writer said? He said, leap out. Leap out means jumped out. He said that if you want to get a ride, just jump out of the window and come and get a ride. Okay, it was true then. He had stolen the horse. There was no question about it. He had come to invite me to ride or not, as I choose. Now, what is there? Now, when his cousin did not answer his question, okay, he asked him that from where did you stole it? And when he did not answer, that time what happened? That time the narrator came to know that it was what? It was true. He had stolen this horse. And he has just come to him just to know his opinion that he wants to ride a horse or not. Okay, well, it seemed to me stealing a horse for a ride was not the same thing as stealing something else such as the money. Now, children, he was a child. Okay, he was just 9 years old that time. So what he thought? Obviously, he had a desire. He also wanted to ride a horse. So what he thought? He thought that stealing money is something different. It's a crime. Okay, but stealing a horse just for a ride, it's not a crime. Okay, for all I knew, maybe it wasn't stealing at all. He said that stealing a horse is not considered as a stealing. Why? Because we are not stealing anybody's money. He was a child. And he was thinking that stealing money is wrong according to our tribe, but stealing a horse just for a ride, it's not wrong. Okay. If you were crazy about horses, the way my cousin Moritz and I were, it wasn't stealing. He said that if the people are crazy, okay, he said that if you are crazy about this horse, riding a horse, just like me and my cousin, so I think it is not considered in a stealing. So it means he was just giving he is just satisfying his heart and his mind by telling this thing that stealing a horse is not a crime. Stealing a horse is not considered in a stealing, in a thieving something. But stealing money is wrong. Okay, so he was just giving a satisfaction answer to himself. Okay, I wouldn't become it wouldn't become stealing until we offered to sell the horse, which of course I knew we would never. He said that of course we are not considering any crime. Why? Because we only stole the horse just for a ride. He said that it will considered in a crime when we are going to sell this horse, then we are doing something wrong. But if we are just what we are doing, just getting a ride on a horse by stealing it, then it is not a crime. He was a child, so he was thinking according to that only. Let me put on some clothes, I said. Now, what did the writer said? He also agreed with his cousin, and he said, just wait, let me put on some clothes. All right, he said, but hurry. He said, all right, but be a little hurry. I leaped into my clothes. He said, I just wore my clothes and came out. I jumped down onto the yard from the window and leaped up onto the horse behind my cousin Mom. He said, yes, I just jumped out of the window into the yard and just sat back on the horse behind my cousin. That year we lived at the edge of the town. At the edge means at the corner of the town, on Walnut Avenue. Behind our house was a country. Vineyards, orchards, irrigation ditches. Children, irrigation ditches means man-made channels used to deliver water. Irrigation ditches means man-made channels used to deliver water. You can write the meaning. Okay, irrigation ditches means man-made channels used to deliver water. Okay, and the country roads. He said that the place where we are living, okay, our house, around our house, there's a country and there are vineyards, orchards, and irrigation ditches and country roads, the roads going towards the country. Okay, in less than 3 minutes, we are on Olive Avenue, and then the horse began to trot. T-R-O-T, trot means proceed. Okay, proceed with something. Okay, T-R-O-T, trot means proceed with something. Okay, so he said that in less than 3 minutes, where we are just riding the horse, and how horse took us to Orchard Avenue. And from there, we just proceed further. We started moving ahead. The air was new and lovely to breathe. He said that I'm feeling very good. Okay, the air was lovely. Okay, I was feeling just like in a very nice weather. When a weather is very nice in the rainy season, we feel very nice with the air and everything, the wind which is flowing. He was saying the same feeling I am having. Okay, I'm enjoying it. Fine. The feel of the horse running was wonderful. And he was saying that I was riding a horse, the horse was running. That was also very wonderful. My cousin Lloyd, who was considered one of the craziest members of our family, began to sing. I mean, he began to roar. He said that this cousin has been considered as the craziest member of the family. Okay, and what he started doing, he just started enjoying the weather and he started singing. Now his singing seemed to the author like a roar. It means he's singing very bad. Okay, his voice was not good. Yeah, every family has a crazy streak in somewhere. And my cousin Lloyd was considered the natural descendant of the crazy streak of our tribe. S-T-R-E-A-K. Streak means ways. Okay, he said that every family had a crazy member. Okay, a crazy race. The people of such generations are called crazy in every family. Okay, and in our family, this person, this cousin Morit, is the one who is so crazy. Okay, before him was our uncle Khusro, an enormous man, the powerful head on a black hair and a largest mustache in San Jacobin Valley. He said that before him, we have one more person in our family who was considered as a crazy person, and he was his uncle Khusro, and he was a very big, very tall man. Okay, and he had the largest mustache in the San Jacobin Valley. It's a, we can say, a place, an interior place in California. Okay, a man so furious in temper, so irritable, so impatient, and that he stopped anyone from talking by roaring. And he was saying what was the nature. Now he was describing the nature of his uncle Khusro. He was saying that how he was. He was very furious. He was short-tempered. He's irritated. And you cannot speak in front of him. Okay, he can stop you from speaking. What? By saying, it is no harm. Pay no attention to it. He said that whenever people used to try to speak to him and explain him that there is something wrong going on, what this uncle used to do, he always used to say a single line. He said that it is no harm, just don't pay attention on to it. Okay, that was all no matter what anybody happened to be talking about. Once it was his own son, Arak, running 8 blocks to the barber shop where his father was having his mustache trimmed to tell him their house was on fire. He said that now he was explaining how his uncle was so crazy. Okay, he was saying that once what happened, his son, okay, the uncle was sitting on a barber shop and he was just trimming his mustache. At that time, his son Arak, he just ran towards uncle and told him that his house is on fire. Okay. This man sat up in the chair and rolled. It's no harm, pay no attention to it. He said that what did the uncle say? He was sitting on the barber shop on the chair and he just shouted at his son and told, there is no harm and don't pay attention. Either his son had informed that the house is on fire, then too, what he said, there is no harm, nope, don't pay attention. Okay. The barber says, but the boy says, your house is on fire. So the Kuso wrote, enough, it is no harm, I said. He said, even the barber, the boy was swimming. Okay, that boy also told that, sir, your house is on fire. It's a very big thing. But what did this uncle did? He again shouted at the barber and said that it's no harm, I know. Don't pay attention on it. Okay. My cousin was what considered the natural descendant of this man. Although Morit father was Zorab, who was practical and nothing else. He said that we used to say, the people in their family used to say that this cousin of the author is just like this uncle, who his name was Khusro. He was just like his uncle Khusro. Although the father of Morit, his cousin's father, was very practical man. Okay. That's how it was in our tribe. A man could be a father of his son's flesh, but that did not mean that he was also the father of his spirit. He said that it is in a tribe, and it is in every tribe, okay? That we are the son of our own parents. We are the children of our own parents. But it doesn't mean that our nature and character also belongs to our parents. Okay, we are so different from our parents. Our parents' nature and character is so different, and it is not necessary that we get the same qualities as our parents had. Okay, this distribution of various kinds of spirits of our tribe had been the beginning capricious and vagrant. Capricious means children inconstant change of mood. Inconstant, inconstant change of mood. Capricious means inconstant change of mood. Okay. And vagrant means a person without a settled home or work. Vagrant, V-A-R-G-A-G-R-A-N-T. Vagrant means a person without a settled home or work. Okay, so he was saying that it is in our tribe that some people are, if we talk about ancestors, so in our ancestors, some people are like this only. They constantly change their mood and they are still not settled in life. And those people are called the crazy people in their tribe. Okay, We rode and my cousin Morit sang. For all anybody knew, we are still in a country where, at least according to some of our neighbors, we belong. We let the horse run in long as it left like running. Now he said that my cousin was singing and we were still in our country. And he don't want his neighbors to know that they were riding on a horse. So what they started doing, the horse started running very fast from the certain places. At last, my cousin Morit said, get down, I want to ride alone. He said that at final, my cousin said, just get down. Now I want to ride alone. Will you let me ride alone, I asked. The rider asked that now you are riding alone. Once all, you will give me a chance to ride alone. That's it. That is up to the horse, my cousin. My cousin said, get down. What did the cousin say? You just get down. That is up to the horse. If horse allow you to ride alone, you can. The horse will let me ride, I said. Now, what did the writer said? You don't worry. The horse will let me also to ride alone. Okay, we shall see, he said. Don't forget that I have a way with the horse. Now, what did he say? He said, okay, we will see to it, his cousin said. And he said that you just don't forget that I brought this horse. Okay, this is mine. Well, I said, anyway, you have with this horse, I also have. Now, what did the writer said? He said that, okay, I know that you brought this horse, this is yours. But I also want a ride. For the sake of your safety, he said, let us hope so, get down. Now, what did his cousin said? The writer's cousin, he said that, okay, but right now you just get down. Okay, all right, I said, but remember you have got to let me try ride alone. He said that, okay. The writer said, okay, right now I'm getting down. But once you will give me a chance to ride alone, once I want to try it. I got down and my cousin Warren kicked his heels into the horses and shouted, Vizire, run. V-A-Z-I-R-E. Vizire is the name of the horse. Now, what did he do? The writer, he just got down and his cousin, he just kicked to this horse and he just shouted that by the name of the horse, Vizire, and he told him to run. The horse stood up on its hind legs. Hind legs means, children, the front legs. Okay, the horse, he just raised his front legs, snorted and burst into the fury of speed that was the loveliest thing I had ever seen. He said, what did the horse did? The horse just put his front legs up and he just ran at a very fastly. He ran very fastly and he said, the writer said that when I saw this, I felt so happy. It was the loveliest thing I've ever saw. My cousin Morris raced the horse across the field of the dry grass of irrigation ditch and crossed the ditch on the horse and 5 minutes later returned dripping wet. He said that what happened? My cousin, he took the horse across the dry grass or along the irrigation ditch, and after crossing the ditch, they just came by taking a ride. Alone, his cousin came after 5 minutes, and when he came, they both were what? Wet. Okay, children.